One of the things that is exciting about these developments, but also probably a bit troubling to people, is what happens when you consider that machines can now write poetry, they can produce haiku, machines are writing novels, they're producing music. So is it sensible that within the next few years, maybe a literature course would include not just material, say novels written by humans, but also by machines? Because we've always thought about literature as something that humans produce. That's why we call it part of the humanities. Do we have to change that? Do we have to include machines in this? If we think about the fact that there's a company, IBM, they have their Watson cognitive computing system, and IBM is emphatic about not saying artificial intelligence. They say cognitive computing, because they insist the machines are actually thinking.
For all of science, we've had two ways of making discoveries. You either run an experiment or you do a survey of people. We now have all the instrumentation we need to passively collect all the information about every person all day long. There's sensors on your skin, they're your mobile phones, your emails, and we can gather all of that information. Embedded in that information is great new insights about your individual behavior and the behavior of the masses. With it, we're likely to be able to create new laws of human behavior. Look, so the biggest thing about computational social science is it's really the engine that's driving our future discoveries. And those discoveries will be put into machines. Once they're put into machines, the biggest collaborator for everyone in the future is unlikely to be a friend or a family member or anybody in their network. It's going to be a machine.